Hi students, welcome to Bosco Campus Vision. I am Darshana, hope all of you are fine. Let us continue our studies. We are discussing the literary genre of fiction. We already studied what you mean by fiction, its characteristics, different types of fiction, fable, etc. Today we are going to discuss short story, one of the sub-genres of fiction. Let us discuss in detail. Then, what do you mean by a short story, or how can we define this term, that is short story? A short story is a piece of prose fiction that can be read in one sitting. Yes, that is a simple definition that we have given to this particular form. It is a piece of prose fiction that can be read in one sitting. That means we can complete the reading of a short story in one sitting. And it focuses on a self-contained incident or series of linked incidents. That means it focuses on a self-contained, in the sense means that is everything is complete within itself. The storyline, development of the plot, character stage, everything is complete within itself. That means it focuses on a self-contained incident or series of linked incidents. And it evokes a single effect or mood. It produces a single effect or mood upon the readers. Then when we consider the length of the short story, it is shorter than a novel and usually dealing with a few characters. So this is the simple definition that we have given to this particular literary form, short story. And what do you mean by short story? A short story is a piece of prose fiction that can be read in one sitting. It focuses on a self-contained incident or series of linked incidents. It evokes a single effect or mood. And it is shorter than a novel and usually dealing with a few characters. Then regarding the origin of this particular form, that is, it was originated in the 19th century. Yes, it is believed that this particular literary form was originated in the early 19th century, that the short story came to its own because of the rise of the magazines like General Magazine and Little Magazine. Yes, it is believed that the short story became popular with the rise of the magazines like General Magazine and Little Magazine in the early 19th century. Then the origin of the form is traced back to Boccaccio's Decameron and Cervantes' Exemplary Tales. This Boccaccio's Decameron is 1350 publication and Cervantes' Exemplary Tales is 1650 publication. That means this particular literary form, that is a short story, its origin is traced back to, yes, Boccaccio's Decameron and Cervantes' Exemplary Tales, and that is means very early, that is in the early 13th century, 16th century, etc. It is important that this particular literary form is traced back to Boccaccio's Decameron. This Boccaccio's Decameron, you already studied, that is in your history paper, that Geoffrey Chaucer's Canterbury Tales. This Canterbury Tales was based on Boccaccio's Decameron. Yes. So, it is traced back to Boccaccio's Decameron and Cervantes' Exemplary Tales. Then James Joyce, one of the modern novelists, notes that a short story focuses on a simple incident. Yes, according to the modern novelist named James Joyce, he notes that a short story focuses on a simple incident or a moment of sudden insight, which he calls an epiphany. Yes, there is a new term for you, that is epiphany. That is, it is this particular term was put forward by this James Joyce. And a moment of sudden insight, that is a particular moment of sudden revelation or sudden change or sudden insight, that sudden revelation that he calls as epiphany. And he defines, or he notes, that a short story focuses on a single incident or a moment of sudden insight, which he calls an epiphany. And regarding the other criteria or other characteristic features of short story, yes, it is short in length. And Moreover, it is flexible in nature. That means the length varies from writer to writer. According to the writer's thirst, it may vary. The length of the short story may vary according to the writer's taste. That is from writer to writer. Then Edgar Allan Poe, in his two reviews of Nathaniel Hawthorne's, Edgar Allan Poe, one of the famous American poets. In his two reviews of Nathaniel Hawthorne, another famous American novelist. So, Poe, in his two reviews of Nathaniel Hawthorne's, defines this genre as a short prose narrative requiring from a half hour to 1 or 2 hours in its perusal. Perusal sense means the act of reading. That means he defines this particular genre as a short prose narrative, and it requires only from a half hour to 1 or 2 hours in its perusal. That means we can complete the reading of a short story within a single sitting, that is within 1 or 2 hours, in which incidents are chosen with utmost care so as to produce a single effect. I already told you it evokes, or it produces a single effect or mood upon the readers. So the incidents are chosen with the utmost care to produce such a mood upon the readers. Then practitioners of this form have stressed the fact that short fiction must be microcosmic. Yes, practitioners in the sense means those who write short stories, that is the practitioners of this form. That means short story writers, they have stressed the fact that short fiction must be microcosmic. They insisted, or they emphasized, that a short story must be microcosmic. Microcosmic in the sense, that means it should showcase the world in a small canvas. A short story should showcase or portray the whole world in a small canvas. When we consider the length of the short story, it is shorter in length, that is compared with the other literary genres like novel, etc. So it should showcase the world in a small canvas. Then regarding the characteristic features of short story, that is harmony is crucial in a short story. It is important. That is in the first point, and in the earlier point, that Edgar Allan Poe insists that incidents are chosen with utmost care. That means harmony is crucial and important in a short story. And individual events, characters, and incidents should come together as a single unit. Yes, this individual events, characters, and incidents should come together as a single unit. That is, all these elements together constitute that, or together produce that effect or that single mood upon the readers. All these elements together constitute that harmony to a particular short story. So harmony is crucial in a short story. And all these elements, that is the individual events in a short story, characters and incidents, all these should come together as a single unit to produce, to make a short story harmonious one, or to produce that single effect or mood upon the readers. Then repetition should be avoided. Yes, and compression and concentration are emphasized in short story writing. So repetition should be avoided, and compression and concentration are emphasized or advocated in short story writing. Then another writer named Truman Capote says the rhythm of a story can be wrecked by a single disharmonious sentence or even a wrong punctuation mark. The above sentence, or in the above point, we already discussed that, yes, all the elements, that is individual events, characters and incidents, all should come together to produce that single effect or mood upon the readers. All the elements together constitute that harmony. So even a single disharmonious sentence or even a wrong punctuation mark can damage or hamper the rhythm of a story. So it is important that the rhythm of a story can be wrecked by a single disharmonious, even a single disharmonious sentence or even a wrong punctuation mark can hamper or can damage the rhythm of a story. Then catchy openings and powerful endings are considered factors which add charm to the form. Yes, it is insisting that catchy openings and powerful endings. For example, the openings of Anton Chekhov's short stories. Just go through his short story. Openings are wonderful. His short story openings are wonderful. That means catchy openings and powerful endings. For powerful endings, that is James Joyce short stories. For example, Dubliners. The endings of Joyce's short stories are wonderful. That powerful endings are considered factors which add charm to the form. For catchy openings, we can consider Anton Chekhov's short stories as examples. And for powerful endings, we can consider James Joyce's short stories like Dubliners are considered as examples. So catchy openings and powerful endings are considered factors which add charm to the form. And it does not tolerate loosely held episodes and digressions. I already told you it should be a harmonious form. That means it does not tolerate loosely held episodes or incidents or character sketches and digressions, etc. Everything should be in a proper and a well-suited way. That is, the plot development of a short story should be well-organized. Then, the French writer Maupassant is considered to be the master of this genre. It is believed that this French writer named Maupassant is considered to be the master of this particular literary genre, that is, short story. Other writers who specialize in this form are O. Henry, Isaac Babel, Catherine Mansfield, Frank O'Connor, George Lewis Box, Raymond Carver, and Alice Munro. Other practitioners or other writers who specialize in short story writing. They are O. Henry, Isaac Babel, Catherine Mansfield, Frank O'Connor, George Lewis Box, Raymond Carver, and Alice Munro. So, what do you mean by this short story? How can we define this term? Yes, it is a short prose narrative which can be read in one sitting and it focuses on self-contained incidents and it evokes single effect or mood upon the readers and shorter in length compared with the other literary genres like novel. Then, catchy openings, powerful endings, does not tolerate loosely held episodes and digressions, then it may be harmonious one. The French writer Maupassant is considered to be the master of this genre. Hope all of you understand this session. That is what you mean by the term short story. There is a homework for you. That is define short story. Write your homework and send back to me. Thank you. Have a nice day. See you again.